Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome to Winners Win. My name is Ted Koka, and this is an exciting podcast about business, technology, Africa, and the playbook on entrepreneurship. I've been thinking severely about something that we're living through, and it hit me. It hit me, and it was almost, in a very weird way, somewhat poetic. And I started with this whole, I know what it feels like, and it really felt like a revelation. I know what it feels like to live through a major transition of what you've been used to. When life as you know it and understand it is just not going to be the same anymore. And it's an irreversible fact that you have to accept. AI is our modern day transition. I had a moment and I realized that I know what it's like to be a farmer and the tractor is invented. I know what it's like to be a candle maker the day electricity came to town. I know what it's like to be a taxi driver when Uber hit the App Store. I know what it's like to own a typewriter the day someone said it's called a computer. I know what it's like to sell horses the year Henry Ford made the Model T. I know what it's like to be Blockbuster the night Netflix went online. I know what it's like to be Kodak holding the film whilst the world went digital. I know what it's like to build a business on CDs just as streaming took over. I know what it feels like to laugh at email until it replaced my fax machine. I know what it's like to be a publisher the day the internet gave everyone a voice. I know what it's like to be a record label watching a kid go viral on TikTok from his or her bedroom. That is what AI feels like today. You can ignore it. You can fight it. Or you really have to learn to ride the wave. Ultimately, AI is the next tool in the long lineage of human evolution. I think we've been here before as humanity. And I'm watching a lot of people. I watched myself first struggle with it and develop these fears. And I'm watching a lot of people develop those fears in their businesses, in their personal life, how to adapt. And I've sort of come to this point that I want to share what I think are 10 human fears about the AI era and the AI transition, and how I think you should see them as opportunities. I'm going to treat this as rapid fire. It's not deep stuff, but I'm going to personalize it and go through those fears and then explain what I think the opportunity is. Number one is, I am going to lose my job. So if you said this to yourself, I'm going to lose my job, I want you to understand that the opportunity is to learn how to automate the mundane and the boring things in your role. You have to upskill yourself in prompt engineering, and then position yourself to lead AI wherever you are, in a department, in a business, in your home life. Position yourself so that you are not replaced by it. The ones who understand the tools become the ones in demand. That's a very important thing. Number two, this is moving too fast. I can't keep up. I think that's a feeling all of us get. There are too many tools being launched, too many, on too many platforms in too many ways. I think you have to slow it down. The opportunity in it is that speed is your advantage. You just have to become familiar with one really great, powerful tool that advances your use case in the best way possible. I think that speed is your advantage. It's not the enemy. You have to focus on being an agile learner, which then equates to exponential growth. The discomfort is the invitation. That's what a lot of people are uncomfortable about even jumping in. So jump in before the door closes. Number three, this will destroy human creativity. The opportunity is that you have to use AI to amplify your own creativity, not replace it. I've learned that this is a major plus and a major win. Great ideas are still yours. I think that AI just gives them wings, pun intended. Number four, it's too complex. I don't get the tech. Understandable, but the reality is that most of these tools are no-code tools or low-code tools. And once you start using them, just intuitively, they make sense. And a lot of people are using them. I think ChatGPT now has about 300 million users a day. That's a tool that's built for the masses, right? So it makes a ton of sense. The future won't be won by coders alone anymore. But I think it's also won by those who dare to learn. Coders used to have that box cornered. That's no longer the case. It's open to everyone. Number five, people will think we're lazy if we automate. I've spoken to a lot of agencies or people who run agencies and feel that if they somehow use an AI automated process, that it's being unfair, or you somehow have an advantage you shouldn't be billing for, etc. I don't agree with that. I think that customers still care about results. They care about speed and they care about personalization. I think you need to focus on that. Ultimately, efficiency is not laziness, it's leadership. And so you need to use these tools in order to lead your industry. Number six, I'll lose control of my brand or my message. I think the opportunity is to train the AI in your voice, some of which is slightly technical, but very doable if you're willing to do the time. Train it in your voice, your tone, your values. And that allows you to scale. It allows you to scale your essence, essentially. AI is the loudspeaker. You're still the message and you're still the voice. Number seven, it's just a trend. It will pass. I've heard people say this, but I don't think this is crypto hype. It's not the same thing. I genuinely think this is the electricity of our time. I think that early adoption equals to massive compounding advantages. And I think that you ignore it at your own peril. Number seven, it feels inhuman. I've heard a lot of people say that. I think you, for those, especially in business, you want to free your teams from repetition so that they can focus on relationship. We still have those. I think that you need to get to a point where AI does the grunt work, you do the human work. Number nine, we've always done it this way. Well, exactly, which is why it's time to evolve. It's time to evolve your business, it's time to evolve how you operate, it's time to evolve how you execute. And this era, these tools give us the opportunity to do that. I think that staying the same right now, for whatever reasons you might think, it's way too risky to not move forward with this. And then number 10 is, what if we get it wrong? I think that we'll definitely get some of it wrong, but stagnation is failure. Stagnation is failure. And I think that, sort of mastery comes from movement. The hardest thing from it is going to be the fact that you suck for a very short period of time. And then once you begin to master it, you become a lot stronger. And that mastery can only come from execution and iteration, execution and iteration. It's very cliche, but you have to fail forward. You have to course correct, and then you have to win faster. In closing, I want to remind you, I want to encourage you to explore these tools. I think you should tinker with them. You should embrace them. You should pace yourself, but set real goals that move you forward. And I think that, again, for those of us who are wondering what it felt like, this is what it feels like today. You can ignore it, you can fight it, or you can learn to ride the wave. If you've made it this far, I appreciate it. Please share your comments. Tell a friend to tell a friend. Like, subscribe. And I'll see you on the next episode. We out.